Hello everyone, welcome to this video. I'm going to show you today how to use nested scenes in OBS. Now this is a feature, I'm not sure exactly which version it was introduced in, but I'm definitely sure from version 18, 19, and now the release today, version 20, allow you to do. A nested scene allows you to take something that you've created. For example, over here we have like the Warframe overlay, the PUBG overlay. You can create a scene in OBS and then place that scene in another scene, allowing you to nest them. Now, one of the main questions is, why would you do this? One of the ways that I use it is that I create an overlay. So here you can see very, very faintly, I have a watermark in the bottom left, and that actually lights up, activates, and provides information to my viewers about following and subscribing and like partnerships with companies like Humble. On the right-hand side, you can see my BitCup and the event system. There you go, it's going off now. So why would I nest this rather than just directly embed each of these layers into my scene? And the reason for that is I can globally turn all of my overlays off at the same time rather than one by one. So if we're watching a cutscene of a game and I want to turn off my webcam, I want to turn off my overlays and just focus on the game, I can do it globally rather than having to individually turn off each single piece one by one. So what I do is I create a scene over here. Let's go to like the PUBG, for example. I have the events list below because we have the map that would generally be in this area. I have the BitCup on the left hand side, so again it's not obscuring this area, and I have my watermark down here. I have all of the areas in this part labeled as sources. But then what I can do in my gaming scene, in my main scene, you can see that I have these overlays here. So if I turn on the PUBG one, I can turn it on and off like so. If you have something like an Elgato Stream Deck, you can also assign it to one of the buttons to turn it off and on very, very quickly and easily, rather than having to, you know, slide over or tab out and turn anything off. You have a lot of control over that stuff. The other thing you can do with this, which you'll be seeing on screen now, is if you have a green screen, you can actually color correct your webcam without actually messing it up. So usually if you use a Logitech webcam, you'll be able to like set the white balance and the autofocus and like the exposure and the gain. But if you want to turn it into something like a silhouette, what you need to do then is add additional color correction on top. And one way that you can do this is you add in another scene. So what you do is you nest your camera into one of these scenes here, like without any of the other stuff, for example. You then bring that into your main gaming composition, not composition, scene, sorry, as a source, and then you can right click, add a filter, add something like color correction, like so, and you'll see the bit cup kind of go down. You can then bring this down and turn it into a silhouette. So if you want to do that with your webcam, you use a green screen, I would recommend using a green screen for this. This is how you can do that. It actually won't affect the underlying camera, so you can turn this off and on rather than having to go in and manually tweak it every single time. And it's just a filter, and it allows you to add additional layers of filters and effects on top of a webcam or on top of a scene without actually affecting the source input of either the camera feed or the rest of your overlays. So that's a very, very quick, simple overview of how to nest these scenes. And you simply add them like you would any other source. Is you just either, you know, right click, you click this little plus down here, and it's just right there, and you choose which scene that you want to add, and it brings it in just like anything else. So thank you very much for watching. I'm sorry this was a little bit longer than it probably needed to be. If you have any questions, you can tweet at me at camcoderkid. You can find me on twitch.tv/camcoderkid. And yeah, hopefully I'll make a couple more of these videos and we'll figure out some cool ways to use some of the effects in OBS.